Okay, so let's talk about the prices, right? First things first, you need to know it's all because of me.
First of all, Amy, thank you so much for these amazing shirts. Amy made us some amazing shirts. She picked pink. Amanda didn't want pink. Amanda said pink was going to make her look fat on TV, but we went with pink because we knew bright and pop, and they're going to sit us in the
And I
front.
had the pleasure of experiencing the Price is Right with Amanda, Amy, and Tessa. So, we're gonna give you an account of what happened that
This is
day.
after Amanda wakes up and is sick all morning because she's so nervous because she's so excited about being on The Price is Right.
Amanda was super excited about going, maybe more nervous than
Acting
excited.
all weird, Amanda. Why y'all nervous and doing this and that? And I was like, because this is my dream. Amanda's dream, Amanda's lifelong dream has been to go on a game show and win big.
Get to the studio, we go through the line, we sign away our lives. There's all this paperwork you have to fill out.
You get to fill out our name tag, and then we wait. And then we wait. And then
Plus,
we
we
wait.
made friends along the way, and then she even got in some trouble. So she started doing a Facebook Live while she was there.
Amanda's going live. She's like, "Hey guys, everybody say hey. Have your phone everywhere."
I'm being me. I'm like, this is, everybody knows this is my dream. So I'm on my Facebook Lives. I'm like, look where I'm at. Price is right. Blah, blah, blah. You know, talking to people, Facebook Live, showing them the stuff. Here comes the security.
The lady who was working there gave Leanette a piece of tape to put over Amanda's mouth because Amanda would not stop running her mouth.
But I seem to remember Lynette asking for the tape to tape my mouth shut. Not that the lady just offered, here's some tape, tape her mouth shut. No, Lynette's like, can I have some of that tape to tape her mouth shut? Already she's trying to throw me under the
It was
bus.
finally time for the interview. This is where I put my game face on. I'm like, I'm gonna do this. I love Amanda, I love my other girls, but I want to get on stage. It's time for me to
But get to
represent.
Lynette first. Now, she might say it differently, but I seem to remember her saying, you know, they gonna want diversity. They gonna want, I'm gonna use my Latina card. Or I mean, she might have used not exact words, but basically she's saying, oh, I'm gonna really play this up because they gonna want
You know, I'm
diversity.
Latina. Hard to hide the fact that I'm Latina, and I'm going to represent that. So when it was my turn, they asked me who I was, and I'm like, I'm Leanette, I'm a Latina blogger.
I'm Latina blogger. She rolled. Don't you they even? She rolled her
He
L's.
talks to Lynette forever. It was so funny. He was asking her what her favorite game was. Lynette couldn't remember any game. She said she liked the big wheel. He was like, that's not a game.
Leanette kind of stole our show. She totally stole the show. We were
Of
all
course, are
like,
they gonna talk to her like, yeah, she was just rolling her L's for 30 minutes straight. Doing her little salsa dances, all that. They're gonna start asking her questions. They stayed on her forever. and here's Amanda like, Lynette doesn't watch the show. She thinks she's here to see Bob
Miss
Barker.
Amanda helping me. She was trying to call me out. She told the guy that I didn't even know who the host was, that I still thought it was Bob Barker. That was sabotage. She said she was trying to help me, but that's not true.
It wasn't sabotage me jumping in. This was just get noticed. I'm like, they running out of time here. They running out of time. We ain't gonna get to talk because they all talk about Lynette not knowing the games. So I'm gonna join in.
So we're all psyched up. We're thinking, yeah, Lynette's going to be on the show. Amanda, whose dream is dying before our eyes, is like
It made
devastated.
Amanda really truly think there was no way she was gonna be picked. And she got a little mad. She got a little feisty.
Amanda starts getting quiet. I think she started thinking that I really had a shot of being called up, and I don't think she liked it all that
Yes,
much.
she was mad at Lynette. Poor Lynette just was being herself. But oh boy, she was mad at Lynette. mad at Lynette for rolling her
Me, I
R's.
always want to go on a game show. This has always been my dream. She was up there. Of course, I'm gonna be upset. And then to top it all off, because she don't know none of the games, right? She don't know none of the games. We get to the other part where you just wait after the interviews and they're showing games up there. Here comes like Amy and everybody trying to teach Lynette the games, because that's how sure they are of her getting And
on.
Tessa and Amy were like, oh my gosh, Leanette, that you did have such a great interview. People behind me were like, oh my gosh, she really liked you. You might have a good chance of being called up. They're all hyping me up. And Amanda's like, okay, if you get called up there, we gotta split our winnings evenly. She was already planting the seed because I think she already thought that I was gonna get called up
I
there.
didn't say nothing about splitting everything evenly. How can you even split stuff evenly on The Price is Right?
What if you win a car? You gotta split the car? Like, we're gonna have joint custody of the car? You get the car these months. You get the car this month.
We go in and they say, we have a spot right for you guys. And they put us right in the front, right behind contestants. Like, we are literally right there, right behind.
Even if we don't get on there, we're gonna be on TV the whole time. Oh, that right there snapped me out of it. I'm like, oh, it snapped me out of it. I'm like, we're gonna be on TV. I'm gonna be behind contestants row the whole time. This is amazing.
So we're front and center. Every time somebody's making a bid, you're gonna see your faces. And that was a little scary, but like, okay, we're there. Yeah, we got good seats. This is awesome.
Whatever. So we all start dancing and grooving and they're playing music and we're having a blast and we're having fun. And
we're sitting down and we're clapping and we're all into it. And my mistake was sitting next to Amanda because she kept clapping in my face. I'm like, oh, this is going to be a long 4 hours.
Look, you can't hear anything. It's super loud in there. So they're like, we have a girl with cue cards. Look for her. See your name. You come on down.
You can't hear nothing, right? You can't hear nothing. So I'm looking at the cue cards. I see the first person. I see the second person.
And even though you couldn't hear anything in there, just this once I hear clear as day, Amanda Taylor, come on down. Amanda didn't hear that because, again, it was so loud. But I look over and I see her. So I see Amanda, see her name on the cue card.
Who do they call down but Amanda? We all flipped out. I thought I was going to pee my pants. I almost started crying because I was so happy for her. She's my best friend. Amanda's my best friend. Love you, boo. Love you. And I knew this was what she wanted. It was like her dream. And I was so happy for her that I was like, I'm going to cry. This is crazy.
The next thing I know, I don't even hear her name. I see a card that says Amanda. Before that could process that it was Amanda, I look over and she's, because she didn't realize that it was her that had been called up. But instead of going on either side, my dear friend decides to climb over the chairs.
Amanda hurdles over. Instead of like walking past people to get there, hurdles over the seats in front of us that are currently empty to get to her spot in contestants' row.
The first thing is an espresso machine. Well, Brett's been like shopping for espresso machines like crazy. My husband has. So I knew it was going to be more money than you would think it would be.
We were like, okay, we're in this together. We're a team. We're going to help her out. We start asking people, like, what do you think the price is?
The woman behind us, we'd actually met her earlier. She was with her family. Her name was Carol. Hi, Carol. So Carol's like, that's really expensive. It's like $1,500. And I was like, oh, my gosh.
And I hear Amy talk about, like, $1,300. I was like, oh, that's high. But if there's anything I knew, my friends were going to be there. They're going to be there asking people, talking about it, discussing prices.
So Amanda hears me, and she's like, okay, but she thinks that's too high. So she bid something in the $900 range?
Amanda gives her answer, and she makes it on stage. We are flipping out. The next thing I know, Amanda's going to go on stage, and she takes off her jacket that she had around her waist, and she throws it to me like I'm a fangirl at a concert catching some person's item.
She rips it off. She throws it behind her, and Leanette has to catch it like a fan in the audience at a concert. So we called her jacket for her. Amanda goes over to play her game. She is playing.
But basically, you're given some items and you need to figure out how to stack them to make it so that, like, this one's the cheapest, then this level costs more than this level, and then this level costs more than these levels.
I remember Drew Carey asking, you see over there the items. You know how to play this game. There's items over there. I was like, I don't know how to play this game, Drew, but I was like, I see some snacks. And I know snacks, so I think I'm all right.
We're trying to help her. One of the products was facial wipes, you know, like the kind you remove your makeup with or something. Well, it's really hard to hear, so you have to, like, do gestures and point.
One of the items was popcorn, so I'm doing like this to try to show to choose popcorn. And one of the things we're talking about, baby wipes. The next thing I know, I see Amanda basically wiping her butt on TV because she's going, wipes? Wipes?
I might have wiped my butt on national TV, but this is for y'all have to think, this is for $100,000. $100,000, I gotta be sure. So we place the items, get $1,000. You wanna stop? No, keep going. $5,000, stop? No, keep going. I get to $10,000. I'm up there, that $10,000. Drew asked, there's only one more level. I could win $100,000, y'all.
And she's like, Should I go? No.
We're looking around and we're like, okay, stop. And she's like, do I keep going? And we're all like, stop, stop, like cut it, like we're done.
Walk away, walk away. She is not paying attention. She's getting ready to live her dream. She's like, I don't know, what do I do? And we're like, stop, stop.
I see my girls over there. They're doing the sign. I see y'all. Y'all want me to stop, be on the safe side. But also in my mind, I'm like, this could be the moment. This could be the moment that, like, everything was meant to be. I'm on a game show, my lifelong dream.
This guy in front of me, there was a couple in front of us, and they were super sweet and charming and funny. And the guy gets the entire audience start chanting, stop, stop.
Stop. So that she would finally stop.
So I stopped and I won $10,000. Yes, I did.
I see her come back out and she's sitting over there and it was a break, so they weren't filming. So I look over and I'm like, thinking, yay, we're all getting money. And Amanda's like.
Then I get over to the side, first one, by myself sitting over there. Look over to my girls like, oh, congratulate me. What's my friends doing? There's my friend Amy. Doing this. Oh, I'm getting paid for this. Already there. Then there's Leanette. She's all talking about she gonna get 1,000. I was like.
Girlfriend who's sitting to my left after she just won $10,000, like, maybe a little.
The only one over there that was, I saw my BFF Tessa. Tessa was over there not talking about wanting money. She was over there just happy for me. We know who real friends are, don't we?
Anyway, so obviously she wins pretty big. We get to the wheel and she spins the wheel. She ends up with like 90 cents or 95 cents. I don't know.
My mic came down. And when I then was spinning, that's when I did my shout outs. I had a long list. I was like to thank my husband. Blah, 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 blah. I did all my shout outs. Right when I was done my shout outs, the wheel stopped. I looked over. It was like 90 cents.
One thing you need to know about me, Amanda's dream was to go in a game show and win big. My dream was to be in the audience of The Price is Right and have Devin be one of the models and for my friend to get on stage and make it to the showcase showdown win so that I could run up on stage and hug Devin because I love Devin.
This is the most stressful part of the whole thing. The first guy spins. He don't spin enough. Like, I don't forgot what he got. And then he's got to spin again. And I'm like, I can't even look. This is so nerve-wracking. He goes over. Or he don't get enough. I don't remember. He's out. Then the next lady spins. I remember she got something like 75 cents the first spin. I was like, oh my Lord, I might be going to the showcase showdown. There's only a couple of numbers that she can get to beat me. Like two numbers that she can get to beat me.
So only one possible thing could beat Amanda. And the woman got it. There go my dreams. No Devin for me. And to put like insult to injury, Devin had to showcase a water boat. He was in a swimsuit, shirtless.
But it was a blessing in disguise because honestly, that final showcase was really hard. And Amanda even said she would have done the exact same thing that other girl did and would have lost it. But
it was such an amazing experience. And although I would have loved to have been on stage, if it could have happened to any one of us, besides me, I'm so glad that it happened to Amanda because it really was one of her dreams to get on stage. So I'm so happy that she won.
Amazing time. It was so much fun. We danced around and had a blast. Amanda won some money and an espresso machine. You can't go wrong there. And she wiped her butt on national television. So, you know, it was a blast.